What's going on, y'all, man? I know it's a little bit loud out here and everything, but I'ma grease my fifth wheel. I asked the company to grease the truck when I had it in the shop a little while back. And they talking about, well, we only grease the truck when we do a BPM. Pretty much a mid-trip inspection. And I was like, well, I don't care, I'm paying for the truck. So, do that. Well, at the end of the day, they still didn't do it. And so now I got a truck. It's the same truck, but I gotta somehow I gotta grease the truck, but I ain't gonna grease the full truck today. I'll do it next time I go home. I'm just looking over some things while I'm here. You know, pretty much doing my pre-trip back here while the truck ain't hooked up to the trailer, obviously. But I'm gonna do part of my pre-trip back here, like I said, while it's not hooked up, so I can kind of shorten it in the morning when I leave. I'm on a 34 reset, so that's all that I'm doing. I'm gonna go ahead and grease the truck a little bit. Well, grease my fifth wheel actually, and then from there, that'll be that. So sit back, watch, like it, comment, subscribe, share, and do all the other good stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a quick on how I grease my foot. I'm gonna throw this bag away right quick. Going back to what I was saying, that's how I grease my fifth wheel. Now, there are many ways to grease your fifth wheel. There's a lot of people that do it differently than I do it. And I'm not knocking them. I'm not saying they're doing it right. I'm not saying they're doing it wrong. I'm just showing you how I do it, how I learned to do it when I was in the service. You know, some people, they put grease all the way up here, and if you see right here, this line right here, all the way across, that way that trailer come off that fifth wheel at. So when I back up, the trailer is going to hit the fifth wheel right there, and when they hit the fifth wheel right there, that's the pivot point. Everything above that is going to push it right on off. So that's why I do it how I do it, you know. And push all of that right on off, the rest of it's gonna grab and it's gonna slide it forward anyway. So I've always greased my fifth wheel that way. Never had a problem with it, you know, and that's about it. I got me a load of rolls of plastic, right? Or rolls of paper. I think it's plastic though, more than paper. But I'm finna show y'all how this thing look, because I think they cut the grass today. That's a little lower. I'm gonna show y'all what my load is. It's all suicide rolls. This is my load. Load of I want to say this plastic type deal. Yeah, it's a plastic type. But I got 8 rolls at 34,000 pounds. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then another 4 up there. Now, how they secure it this here? I'm gonna show y'all on the back row how they secured it. All they did was put some wood in the ground, put some wood in the deck. And I think these big rubber blocks, yeah. It's sitting on these rubber blocks. You got 2 in the back and 2 in front of the front row. And then you got these cardboard cradles that are hollowed out in the center to fit the roll. You got 1 on this side, 1 on that side. For this roll, and then the same thing for that roll, and the same thing for the last roll of the 4 in the front. Those straps, I put those straps on there because I was a flatbedder. You know, I did flatbed for a little bit when I was with Prime. So I know the dangers of these rolls. The place inside of this truck is called suicide. Reason why it's called suicide, because if you slam on the brakes and them things start rolling forward, they're gonna go through the front of that trailer and into the back of that cab. They say the driver commits suicide when he do that. Not necessarily saying the driver wants to do that and everything. It just might be, you know, those things that we call four-wheelers and whatnot. They might cut you off or something like that. And if they do, then you screwed. I mean, the only thing you can do is slam on the brakes if somebody cut you off. Slam on the brakes or run into the back of them, and I mean, the truck still stops suddenly anyway, so either way it goes, if it stops suddenly, then it's a problem. So they break loose and they roll forward and end up seriously injuring the driver, or killing the driver.
Y'all hold on while I get down out of this truck. Oh shit, I gotta get my my glove. But yeah, that's about it, man. That's my load. It's a live unload, so I can't show that because I can't be, most of the time you can't be inside the dock while they unloading the trailer. But this is what I got. This is where I'm at. This is what I'm doing. This is it. So. That's how I grease my fifth wheel. Like I said, there's no right or wrong way. Depending on who you're talking to, I did it wrong. Depending on who you're talking to, I did it right. What's going on, man?
Not much, you.
Oh man, just trying to film, do some vlogging or something. But ain't no right or wrong way when greasing your fifth wheel. Just gotta do what you gotta do. Appreciate y'all. Y'all have a good one. And I'll talk to y'all later. Now it's time to hook back up to the trailer. So the next thing I do after I back up and hook up to the trailer, you do this every time you connect to a truck, a trailer. I don't know if y'all can see that too good, but up there, you look at the jaws and make sure the jaws wrap around the kingpin of the trailer. But the jaws have locked around it, so, and I did a tug test also, so I ain't got to worry about that. So now I'm just looking, just look down here now to see what, if I got something I can do, or just checking out some stuff. But that's pretty much it right there. Now I let my landing gear back up, connect my air lines as I already did. My electrical lines, I connected those. And now I finished letting my landing gear up, and that's it. That's it, that's all we got. And for guys like me, who do a lot of dropping hooks, I'm always connecting and disconnecting, so most of the time I have ample time of greasing my fifth wheel if I don't get in a rush. If I get in a rush, I just connect, disconnect. Connect, disconnect, that's it. But key to it is not getting in the rush so you can take care of your equipment. You take care of your equipment will take care of you. But like I was saying, y'all, man, that's all I need to do. That's all I do. Hook up, disconnect, point A to point B. Yeah, I'm on my 34 reset. I'll be leaving here about maybe 8 in the morning, 9 in the morning. I might leave there at 9 in the morning. That's another 13 hours from now. My 34 will be up before the end though, but I can't deliver till noon. I'm 100 miles away. But that's what we do. I appreciate y'all. Y'all have a good one.